legal advocacy for girls and women in sports. And this issue of sexual abuse in club Olympic sports has been going on for about 20 years. And there are people here in this audience who have been working very hard, including back here, over 20 years to try to make it better within sports, and frankly, were unsuccessful. So I'd like to call out Jen Say, who wrote a book called Chalked Up. I'd like to call out Jennifer Spiegel and her and Jessica Armstrong, and together with some very elite gymnasts, wrote a letter in 2012 that went to the United States Gymnastics, and they were ignored. There were comments that the kind of things that are in this legislation, the best gymnasts in the country were unable to do. In 2014, I represented 19 victims of sexual abuse in the sport of swimming. And as a result of that, we got Chuck Wildes out of the Hall of Fame. Just a few months later, the Olympic Committee honored him, honored Chuck Wildes. Rather than getting fired, rather than having anybody hold anybody account, nobody lost their job, no board position got lost. The big difference is we had the Me Too movement where people believed that it happened. And then we had these women here, the 156 women who showed the depth of the emotional harm that happens as a result of sexual abuse. But I don't think until this moment, until they spoke, that they made it real for people what this means. So not only do people know that sexual harassment and abuse is ubiquitous in women's lives, is a part of women's lives, but also just how damaging it was. It was so vulnerable and yet so powerful. I was so impressed with them, and because of them, this bill has been passed the Senate in November, and now here we have, and right after they spoke, bam, passes the House. So all credit goes to them. It wouldn't have happened without so many people. But I really want to thank Senator Feinstein for really listening to the people who came forward initially and to be able to make this issue happen. I've been involved in a little statute called Title IX for all of my professional career. It passed 45 years ago. The passage of this statute is just the beginning. We're at the starting line right now. So everybody is going to take a village to change a culture of sport that values emotional harm, that thinks that that's motivation. That's going to take a sea change of different thinking of who can be on a board who came from a sport that grew up thinking that being physically and emotionally abusive was normal. And that's what sets somebody up for sexual abuse. It's not just gymnastics, it's not just swimming. It's in, trust me, every single sport, and as I like to describe it, it's kind of like ice cream. There's just 47 different flavors of how it happens, what makes each sport uniquely vulnerable to sexual abuse, but it happens across sport. So I'm thrilled that we now have statutory protections for these 8 million children. And again, I want to thank all the people who've been involved for years and years, and the people who are involved in this effort, and particularly these athletes who made the change. Thank you very much.